Welcome back. In this mini lesson, we will continue to analyze different procedures that need to be followed during the Monte Carlo simulation of neutron transport. This time we will look at how to sample the type of reaction that occurs after the neutron collision on some nucleus. So let's assume that we are simulating the neutron transport in some material which is composed on a variety of different nuclides. So in order to sample the reaction type, we have to decide first what kind of nuclide the neutron collides on. And in order to be able to select the nuclide and eventually the type of reaction, we need to know the probabilities that the neutron collides on a specific nuclide and the probabilities for different reactions. And in order to calculate these probabilities, we have to work with cross-sections. Now, there are many different kinds of cross-sections, so now let's take time to review the basic cross-sections. So let's start with the microscopic cross-section that we denote by sigma. The unit of the microscopic cross-section is barn, typically, which equals to 10 to the minus 24th of square centimeter. So the microscopic cross-section is an area. It's not a probability, however, it's proportional to the probability. So if you increase the microscopic cross-section twice, then the probability of the reaction will increase twice as well. We have two indices for the microscopic cross-sections denoting different nuclides. So the I index denotes the nuclide and the J index denotes the reaction. So we have cross-sections for different reactions. It can be neutron capture. We can denote them by the index C, or it can be the fission induced by the neutron. We can denote it by F. And we can have also cross-sections for neutron scattering that we can denote as S. A complication to our simulation is the fact that the cross-sections in general are dependent on the neutron energy. So as the neutron scatters and loses its energy, the cross-sections change accordingly. The fact that the microscopic cross-sections are dependent on the neutron energy represents a big difficulty to the Monte Carlo simulation, because the dependence is pretty complex. It cannot be expressed in terms of some simple analytical function. So the data for the neutron cross-sections, they need to be stored in table forms. So we have very large tables in which for different energies the cross-sections for different nuclides and different reactions are stored. So these tables, they can be very long. In principle, we need many gigabytes of data to describe accurately the cross-sections for different reactions of different nuclides. So this is a problem, because as the neutron scatters and loses its energy, the cross-sections change. So every time we need to find the correct cross-section, the library needs to be searched for the energy that is closest to the energy of the neutron, and then the corresponding cross-sections can be read from the library. And this procedure you have to repeat for every nuclide that is in the material and every reaction that could possibly occur during the collision. Now, the selection of the reaction is not the only procedure that requires the cross-sections. You may remember when we sampled the distance to the next collision, we also needed the total microscopic cross sections. We are going to talk about this in the next slide. And for this purpose, the microscopic cross sections also need to be recovered from the library. So this procedure of finding the correct energy in the library can be computationally quite expensive, and quite considerable part of the Monte Carlo simulation is spent on finding the correct data in the cross-section library. Let's have a look at the next cross-section, which is the total microscopic cross-section for a specific nucleide. So the total microscopic cross-section combines all the microscopic cross-section for the corresponding nucleide. So these will be cross-sections for different reactions, but they all belong to the same nucleide. Another quantity that we are going to work with is the concentration of the nucleide. So we are going to denote it by the capital N, and it just gives the number of the atoms of the specific nucleide per unit of volume. So typically the unit is 1/cubic centimeter. And another quantity that we need to know is the macroscopic cross-section of specific nucleide for a specific reaction. So again, we have the two indices, the index I for the nucleide type and the J index for the reaction type. The macroscopic cross-section is defined as the product of the microscopic cross-section of the corresponding nucleide and the reaction, and the concentration of the corresponding nucleide. The unit of the microscopic cross-section is 1/unit distance, so typically 1/1 centimeter. Another quantity is the total microscopic cross-section for a specific nucleide. So again, this cross-section combines all the cross-sections describing the different reactions of the specific nucleide. So we just sum over all the microscopic cross-sections of different reactions that belong to the nucleide that we study. And finally, we need to know the total microscopic cross-section that characterizes the material in which the neutron collides. The total microscopic cross-section that we denote as sigma t is a combination of all the total microscopic cross-sections for all nuclides that are present in the material. So we have already used the total microscopic cross-sections before. We have used this quantity when we calculated the distance to the next collision. You may remember that we have used this quantity there. And in one of the previous lessons, we have derived the physical meaning for 1/σt. You may remember that we have derived the meaning as the mean distance between collisions. Alright, so we have introduced all the quantities that we are going to work with. So let's get back to our task of selecting the reaction type. Once we have decided the place for a new collision, the first thing is we have to decide the nuclide, what kind of nuclide the neutron collides on. So we assume that the collision happens in a material which combines different nuclides with different nuclide densities. Now we can sample the type of the nuclide if we know how likely it is for a neutron to collide on the different nuclides that constitute the material. But we know these probabilities because we know the total microscopic cross-section for every nuclide in the material, And we also know the total macroscopic cross-section for the whole material. And we know the probability that a neutron collides on a specific nuclide. It can be calculated as the ratio of the total macroscopic cross-section for the specific nuclide and the total macroscopic cross-section for the whole material. So we have to calculate this probability for every nuclide that is present in the material in which the collision takes place. So once we know all these probabilities, we can easily use the inverse transform method to sample the type of nuclide on which the collision takes place. So once we select the nuclide type, we need to select the type of interaction, the neutron reaction. And we can follow exactly the same procedure as before. We can assign a probability for each reaction for the specific nuclide. So we know that the probability for different reactions are proportional to the cross-sections. So it actually doesn't matter here whether you use the macroscopic or microscopic cross-sections, because the macroscopic cross-section is the product of the microscopic cross-section and the nuclide densities, but because they are both in the numerator as well as in the denominator, the nuclide densities would simply be cancelled out. So we can use, for instance, the macroscopic cross-sections here. So we just divide the macroscopic cross-section for a specific reaction by the total macroscopic reaction of the nuclide, and we will get the probability for a specific reaction J. Once we know all the probabilities for all the reactions on this specific selected nuclide, we can again apply the inverse transform method to randomly select the specific neutron reaction that we want to simulate. So that is all. Have a nice day.